of the Faith, Article 2 na po. Yan po, ano? Apostles' Creed, ang pinanggagalingan po yung experience, yung witnessing at yung pagsasali ng ating mga apostoles. Kasi sabi ni Cristo, go and teach. So they taught. And what did they teach? In a summary form po, the 12 articles. Ito po, kitang-kita nyo, nasa Article 2 na po tayo. Artikulo 2. Ang ganda po, I believe, di ba sabi natin, yun ang pinaka-importante word. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. Tinan po natin yung, himayin po natin ng konti yung Jesus Christ, His only Son, and our Lord. Kita nyo, meron tayong dilaw na rectangular box to what are we stressing. Di ba pinaghahambing natin ng konti ang Apostles' Creed at yung na-develop na Nicene Constantinopolitan Creed. Bukas po, pag-uusapan natin why this development. Pero ganito po, Jesus, Yeshua, the Hebrew name meaning God saves. Andyan po yan. Kay Matthew chapter 1, verses 18, no? Nung sinabi kay Joseph in a dream that he would have to name the child Jesus. Ayan po, in the left-hand side, it's a God-given name, itong Jesus. The angel Gabriel said this to Mary in the Gospel of Luke, similarly to Joseph in the Gospel of Matthew. Ano ibig sabihin ito? God calls by name. Bakit? To tell the purpose why this person is being born. Sana po, ano, yung ating pangalan, may ibig sabihin sa life purpose natin. Diba? Hindi lang kung ano-anong salita dyan, kung ano-anong napupulot nating salita. Imagine po, ang inyong apelyido, Bombilla, tawagin mo pa yung anak mo, Iluminada. Kawawa naman, di ba? Bombilla na nga, tinawag mo pang Iluminada. Anyway, tingnan po yung kanan, mas mahalaga eh. Salvation is the mark of Yahweh with His people. When? Starting with Noah. Saved from the flood. Abraham from extermination kasi walang anak. Binigyan ng anak si Isaac. And but then, nung meron ng anak si Jacob, twins pa nga, di ba? Esau and Jacob, si Isaac, Esau and Jacob. Si Jacob, di ba, had the threat of famine kasi walang ulan. And therefore, they experience already in the so-called the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob already experienced salvation from God. But the most unforgettable experience was Exodus from Egypt. First, they crossed the Red Sea on dry ground. And then 40 years in the desert, di sila namatay ng gutom. Although namatay yung marami doon, except one, si Joshua nga. And the entry of these people, over a million people, they were able to go back to where Jacob's family stayed, into Canaan. And they were led by a person called Yeshua, Joshua, in the Bible. The right-hand man of Moses, Moses died not going to the Holy Land, to the Promised Land. But you see, meron connect si Yeshua of the New Testament, that is our Jesus of Nazareth, I believe in the one Lord Jesus, di ba? May pangalan yan, eh, to the Joshua of the Old Testament. Bakit? Si Jesus, up to now, is our Jesus, our Lord, is like Joshua that is leading us to paradise. Ah, mas mahalaga to kesa to bring us to a land where God says, I will give you. Now the land that Jesus is leading us to is really what God wants to give us as His children, adopted children, paradise. That is the real meaning of Yeshua, God saves. Saves us from the evil one, from hell, and we go to heaven. So when we say this, I believe in Jesus, I believe in the one that leads me to salvation. Second, ano ba ibig sabihin ng Christ? This attests that the Jesus of Nazareth, no, Joseph and Mary is from Nazareth, is the Messiah, the Messiah. Puntahan po natin yung kanan. Since after the division of David's kingdom into north and south, Israel and Judah, And the many times Israel was dominated by other kings, especially with the Babylonian exile, there always was the earnest wish to possess again the glory of David's reign. Yun po eh, Davidic kingdom, yun po makikita niyo sa Old Testament. The prophets spoke actually of a return to glory. But sadly, it was wrongly interpreted as merely political. Merely, in a way, economic, material, without bereft of its genuine call. The call to return to glory is to return to God. Glory to God. Eh? Glory. God is glory. To return to God. That means to belong to the servant lordship of God. Maging sakop sa Diyos. Now, this Jewish expectation, as sinabi ko dito sa kanan, of a glorious anointed one, blinded them to see Jesus as the one sent by God to be the Messiah. Bakit? Eh, from Galilee. Can any good come from Galilee? Di ba? There's no prophet in Galilee. Sabi ni Caiaphas. His family, yeah, he doesn't know his father, his brothers, right? Lowly, carpenter. And then his friends were sinners, tax collector, and prostitutes. But above all, his end, so humiliating, crucified as a criminal, the worst criminal. The sentence to the worst criminal is death on a cross. To this day, the Jewish faith does not accept Jesus of Nazareth as their Messiah. But we believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Christ. Third, his only son. This attests that Jesus is related to God, to Yahweh. And it is his only son. Oy, mahalaga yon. Kaya dito po, sa kanan, Nicene Constantinopolitan Creed, bukas pag-uusapan natin mas maigi, his only begotten son. Dinagdagan po ng begotten. Sa Bible po, wala yung begotten eh. Sa Bible, hindi yung makita si begotten. Beloved po. His only but beloved son. Son of God is often applied to a just man. Yung matuwid po tao sa Bible, he is a son of God. Or to the king because he was anointed by a priest or prophet because God said, anoint this man. And so they called the king son of God. They also would call the whole group, the whole family of God, the whole nation of God, Israel, as sons of God. Nevertheless, ito po, this reference is not similar to the way Jesus used it for himself. Not even how the early Christian communities believing in Jesus were taught by the apostolic witnesses, by the apostles, and the disciples who knew Jesus when he was alive. The relationship was not merely moral. Bro, sa ating iba mga charismatic movement, bro, sis, o kaya sa ating mga kabarkada, tol, utol, kaputol, tol. Hindi po, it's not merely moral. It is real. Jesus is really God's only son. Jesus was not simply contented to be called beloved son by the Father. He lived his sonship to the full. Maganda yung may pangalan, oy, son. Pero totoo ba? He never said nor did anything that was not from the Father. He was always po, the obedient son. So I believe in Jesus is the Savior. He is the Messiah anointed because he is God's only son. Not only by name, but above all, by obedience even to death. And therefore, po, fourth, we also believe that Jesus is our Lord. Ikaapat po yan. Jesus is most certainly God, divine. Bakit? Kita nyo sa Apostles' Creed, in Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the one Lord, Jesus Christ, sabi sa Nicene Constant. Just as the Judaism faith, no? Just as Judaism dapat po. professes the belief in one God, so too it calls and relates to the one God as the one and only Lord. Kung iisa po ang Diyos according sa kanilang paniniwala, isa lang po ang kanilang Panginoon. Isa lang po ang kanilang sinusunod. Siya lang, one and only Lord. Yet, again, the apostles use this term of the Jews for Jesus, especially after the experience of his resurrection. Thomas would say, no, my Lord and my God, as example. Pero brothers and sisters, dalawa na ngayon ang Diyos. Diba? Dumalawa. Hindi na siya only one God. Yan. Hindi po naman pinag-uusapan natin yung Divine Trinity dito sa ating next time na po yung Divine Trinity. Napakahaba po usapan yan. Pero sa Apostles' Creed, the word Lord implies divinity. Because the Greek Kyrios and the Hebrew Adonai both mean Lord and are ascribed only to God. So, the use of Lord with Jesus is meant to profess His divinity. That is our faith. The Jesus of Nazareth that we call the Christ, anointed, sent by God. Because He is the only Son, and above all, that sonship He lived to the hilt as an obedient Son to the Father, we call Him Lord. Why? He was raised up from the dead. Diba? My Lord, my God. And therefore, He is God. Jesus Christ, I believe, is God. Okay po? Lana. Ay, next po. Next slide. So sabi natin, what are we doing? We proclaim, we testify. When we say, I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, that is what we tell in words, diba? But how do we show that with our lives? The next slide po as we end. So first, we have to proclaim that Jesus is Savior and Lord. Dapat po nating sabihin, we have always to speak, to proclaim, sa akin si Jesus ay Panginoon ko, manliligtas ko. Sinasabi ng mga born again, my personal Savior. Personal daw. Sa atin, we believe that He is our Savior and Lord. Pero what do we test? How do we live? Ayun po. We want to believe, to say that I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. We have to obey, follow, and worship Him. He is Lord. We have to worship Him. That's why, on every worship, we say, God our Father, but we end with, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you. Diba? Sa liturgy, we use that word, Lord Jesus Christ. Bow na po. Thank you. Salamat. Let's see each other tomorrow. Ay. Thank you.